Chagrin Falls is one of the most popular tourist destinations in Northeast Ohio. It is known for its nationally recognized popcorn shop, two waterfalls, and shopping and dining selections. However, very few people realize the popcorn shop used to be one of 9 mills in the once industrial village. An even less known fact was that Chagrin Falls even had its very own railroad. In this video, we'll cover the history of the railroad branch line and show you what's left of it. Chagrin Falls, Ohio is located 17 miles southeast of downtown Cleveland along the Chagrin River. Early settlers from New England utilized water from the river and established numerous mills that produced flour and paper. 4 miles southwest of Chagrin Falls is the city of Solon. Its vast and wide open, fertile land proved successful for farming. Both Solon and Chagrin Falls are very similar but have much different terrain. While Solon is mainly flat, Chagrin Falls is the exact opposite, having many hills and gorges. As both Chagrin Falls and Solon grew, they needed a faster and cheaper form of transportation to ship and receive their commodities. In 1848, a railroad called the Cleveland and Mahoning Valley was formed to connect the cities of Cleveland and Youngstown, Ohio. Residents in Chagrin Falls, Solon, and other surrounding communities were bustling with excitement once news of this railroad reached them. Chagrin Falls villagers were told by this railroad company that if they purchased $30,000 of their stock, the line would be routed through Chagrin Falls. The villagers did just this, but the company didn't keep their word. After surveying for the potential right-of-way was completed, the company decided to instead route the line through Solon because of its flat land. As the years and eventually decades went on, there were 3 other attempts to build a railroad through Chagrin Falls. All of them failed except for the 1875 incorporated Painesville Canton and Bridgeport Narrow Gauge Railroad. The company stated that as Chagrin Falls residents bought first mortgage bonds, a branch line will be built from Chagrin Falls to the Cleveland and Mahoning Valley and Solon. Chagrin Falls residents complied and purchased the required amount of bonds. Just as quickly as construction started in 1876, it stopped completely in 1877 when the PC&B failed to pay their contractors. Chagrin Falls stock and bondholders were growing frustrated with the PC&B. Not only was there minimal progress being made, but there was also a lack of communication from the company. When a new update finally came, the PC&B would always ask for more money. This is when prominent Chagrin Falls residents Irving W. Pope and John W. Williams came into the picture. Irving Pope was a successful businessman involved in multiple enterprises in Chagrin Falls. He owned a hotel named in his honor and was one of the founding members of the Chagrin Falls Paper Company. He even became the mayor of Chagrin Falls in 1874. John W. Williams was one of the most prominent industrialists in Chagrin Falls. Williams started a foundry called the J.W. Williams & Sons, which produced a wide variety of products like Empire wood-burning stoves and sad irons. In late October 1877, Irving Pope and John Williams led a party of 4 other prominent Chagrin Falls residents and took matters into their own hands. The group of men entered into a contract with the PC&B to finish the railroad. Amazingly, the 5.155-mile line was opened on December 15, 1877. The Chagrin Falls branch began at the Cleveland and Mahoning Valley near Bainbridge Road and Cruz Drive. It terminated at Chagrin Falls in between East Washington and Bell Streets. As mentioned earlier, this was a narrow-gauge railroad. Gauge is the measured distance between both sets of rails. In the case of the Chagrin Falls branch, it was 3 feet. Even though the PC&B Railroad was opened between Chagrin Falls and Solon, the line was poorly constructed. Railroad equipment derailing was a common event as a result. Approximately 5 miles of right-of-way had been partially graded to Twinsburg, but that was the only thing accomplished in extending the line further south. The Painesville Canton and Bridgeport Narrow Gauge Railroad never reached the cities in its name. In June 1878, the Chagrin Falls contractors terminated their contract with the PC&B as the railroad company did not fulfill their terms in the contract. The contractors then took possession of the railroad for their own protection. In 1879, the PC&B sued the contractors and they went to court in 1880. As it was revealed, the PC&B never had any money. Some of the right-of-way acquired for the line was never paid for, and even the printer for the bonds they issued. The PC&B fell into receivership on July 14, 1880. Its receiver then auctioned off all the company's assets to pay for their court costs, the unpaid right-of-way, and reimbursement of the Chagrin Falls contractors. Irving Pope, John Williams, and William Hutchings ended up purchasing the company when it went to auction on September 28, 1880. The three men then incorporated the Chagrin Falls and Southern Railroad Company on September 30, 1880. The CFNS owned two steam locomotives, two passenger cars, two boxcars, and eight platform cars. A wide variety of commodities were hauled over the line, like coal, stone, lime, sand, petroleum, lumber, and general merchandise. There was also a spur which led to a sandstone quarry in Bentleyville, Ohio. While companies in Chagrin Falls were thriving because of this little branch line, in the long run they had a hard time competing with other companies in surrounding towns and cities. This was because the line could not directly transport their products to its destination. An additional step had to be made by transferring it in Solon to the Cleveland-Mahoning Valley, which was a different gauge. Over the years, there had been attempts to extend the line north to principal markets like Willoughby, Painesville, or Fairport Harbor, but neither happened. In 1888, a syndicate which owned the Cleveland and Canton Railroad formed the Cleveland, Chagrin Falls, and Northern Railroad. The Cleveland and Canton was a massive network of consolidated railroads that operated over 160 miles of narrow gauge track between Cleveland and Coshocton, Ohio. The Cleveland, Chagrin Falls, and Northern's purpose was to connect between the Cleveland and Canton and the Chagrin Falls and Southern Railroads. Between 1888 and 1889, 3.04 miles of track was built north from Glen Willow and crossed over the Cleveland and Mahoning Valley to the Chagrin Falls and Southern and downtown Solon. This connection with the Cleveland and Canton by Austin Powder Drive in Glen Willow was called Falls Junction. In 1891, the entire Chagrin Falls branch was converted from narrow to standard gauge. Through a series of mergers, the Chagrin Falls and Southern and the Cleveland Chagrin Falls and Northern ended up in the hands of the Cleveland and Canton Railroad. This railroad was later further consolidated as the Cleveland, Canton, and Southern and was purchased by the Wheeling and Lake Erie Railway in 1899. The Chagrin Falls branch was thriving during the Wheeling and Lake Erie years. However, freight traffic steadily declined after World War II. Passenger service to Chagrin Falls was permanently discontinued in November 1933. In December 1949, the Wheeling and Lake Erie was leased to the Nickel Plate Road. The Nickel Plate, as it turned out, had huge plans for the branch line. In 1951, the Nickel Plate Industrial Development Inc. purchased 1,000 acres of land in Solon that had been rezoned for industrial use. This laid the groundwork for Solon's transition from farming to a suburban industrial community. 26 industries like the Kroger Company and Western Electric had relocated from Cleveland to the Solon Industrial Park. In 1953, the Nickel Plate built a 1.15-mile industrial spur that branches off the Chagrin Falls branch to serve these industries. The industrial park in Solon brought much-needed traffic to the Chagrin Falls branch. However, the portion of the line into Chagrin Falls was increasingly losing customers. In 1988, the Nickel Plate Road successor, the Norfolk and Western Railway, merged the Wheeling and Lake Erie into their successor, Norfolk Southern. 6.25 miles of the Chagrin Falls branch was finally abandoned past the Solon Industrial Spur connection to Chagrin Falls in 1989. In 1990, a group of investors formed the Wheeling Acquisition Corporation and acquired 568 miles of the former Wheeling and Lake Erie from Norfolk Southern. Their acquisition also included the entire 8.5-mile Chagrin Falls branch. The reincarnation of Wheeling continues to serve customers on the industrial spur located at milepost 1.9, although there's only about 4 to 5 customers that still receive rail service. Now, let's talk about what happened to the abandoned 6.25-mile section of the Chagrin Falls branch. In 1992, the city of Solon purchased 2.1 miles of right-of-way between Somm Center Road and the Solon-Bentleyville border. The Cleveland Metro Parks later purchased the right-of-way from the Solon-Bentleyville border to Pine Street in Chagrin Falls in 1998. The Metro Parks later built a walking and biking trail in the early 2000s. Solon tried to do the same with their section in the 1990s and 2018 as of most recently, but both attempts did not work out as there was pushback from homeowners surrounding the right-of-way. In recent years, there have been multiple sections of the right-of-way violated by new developments. In Chagrin Falls, a retirement community was built on some of the right-of-way by South Franklin Street. Another senior center was built last year over the right-of-way by Bainbridge Road in Solon. Overall, evidence of the railroad is long gone, but there are a few remnants left if you know where to look. In Glen Willow, the 1905-built Falls Junction Depot still exists, which is owned by the city. Last year, the depot was moved west from the Wheelings property on the east side of the tracks to Pettibone Park. It is currently still in the process of being restored into a museum. The Chagrin Falls Freight Station also survives. It was purchased in 2001 by Mary Briggs, former Clarendon Township trustee. She had it temporarily moved to the Geauga County Fairgrounds until it was later moved to her property in April 2002. On the Metro Parks Trail, mile marker 6 was left in place. A bridge abutment from where the railroad used to cross over the Aurora branch of the Chagrin River is also still there, although when I visited it, it was hard to see under the heavy brush. That's all for now, thanks for watching. I hope everyone enjoyed this episode of Abandoned Railroads of Northeast Ohio. If you did and want to see more, make sure you like this video and subscribe to the channel.